everyone! In this video, we are going to learn all about LEDs, how they work, how to interface them with prototyping boards like Evive and Arduino, and how to program them in PictoBlocks. Finally, we'll see what wonders we can create using them. Let's begin! Light-emitting diodes, aka LEDs, are tiny light bulb-like devices that glow when current passes through them. There are two important things you need to keep in mind while working with the LEDs. The first is their polarity. Just like batteries, LEDs also have positive and negative terminals. The longer leg is the positive terminal and the shorter one is the negative terminal. They allow current to pass only in one direction, that is, from positive terminal to the negative terminal. To make LED work perfectly, connect the positive terminal to a higher potential than the negative one. The second is their current rating. Their current rating is the maximum value of the current they can withstand. If you pass the current greater than that value, they may blow up. The safe value of current for LEDs is usually around 20 milliamperes. To limit the value of the current, we use resistors, the value of which can be calculated using the Ohm's law. Now that we have basic understanding of the LEDs, let's have a look at how to interface them with Evive and see it in action. Evive already has an LED connected to digital pin 30. Thus, we will focus on writing scripts to control it here. If you want to control an external LED, you can make a circuit like this on Evive's breadboard and connect the positive terminal of the LED to a digital pin through which you want to control the LED. Now let's program the pin 13 LED in PictoBlocks. It is a graphical programming software based on Scratch Blocks. You can download it from the link given in the description box below. Open PictoBlocks. Then click on the board button and select Evive from the drop-down. Now from the dialog box that appears, choose the appropriate serial code. Before writing the script, make sure that the firmware is uploaded. If not, upload it using the upload firmware button. We will write a script to make the LED blink every second. To turn the LED on or off, we will use the set digital pin block from the Evive palette. First, select the digital pin to which it is connected. The default pin is 30, to which our LED is already connected. Now to turn the LED on, select high from the second drop-down menu. Next, add a weight of 1 second. Duplicate the script and place it below the weight block. Now to turn the LED off, choose low from the drop-down. Finally, to run the script continuously, add a forever block. Now, we'll place a well-flat clicked hat block above the forever block. It will ensure that the script runs when the green flag is clicked. Now, we'll check whether the LED is blinking or not by running the script. Since everything is perfectly fine, let's make another script to control the brightness of the LED in real time. To control the brightness, we will use pulse width modulation. It is a technique to reduce the FH voltage at a digital pin by controlling the width of the digital pulse at that pin. Let's make a variable to control the brightness and place it in the blank space of the set PWM pin block. We will use the set PWM pin block from the Evive palette. Add a waiting time of 0.1 second. Next, add a forever block to run the script continuously. Now we'll place a when flag clicked hat block above the forever block. Let's have a look at the output by running the script. Now, let's write the script to make the LED blink in the upload mode so that we can work with Evive without it being connected to the computer. This script will be similar to the first one. The only difference is the hat block. As we are going to upload the script to Evive, we will Wife starts up hack block above the entire script to execute the program. Now, upload the code using the upload button. To know how to work with the LEDs, there are a number of projects you can make using them, like an LED cube, smart LED street light, smartphone controlled LED lamp, persistence of vision, and much more. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up and share it with your friends. For more such educational content, subscribe to STEMpedia.